I'm sure that you have all been there before. It's Sunday morning, you're with your family on your way to a Protestant, evangelical, seeker-friendly church here in America, where you will be going to a church service that is approximately 1 to 1.5 hours long. And as you enter into this church, you are assured to be greeted by greeters that have a welcoming smile, and you will be handed most likely a pamphlet that has a warm welcome to it as well, and that has many of the major verses that the pastor will be using in his sermon. And as you enter into the church, the emotional music is starting to be played, and everybody is sitting there, most likely uncomfortably. A couple people are lip syncing a couple words. A couple people are raising their hands and really getting into the emotion of the music. And a majority of people are sitting there uncomfortably waiting for the sermon to start. And this will go on for approximately 15 to 25 minutes. And when this is over, the pastor will then step up and give his 30 to 35 minute message, where he will first open up his message with a joke about some major league sports player, some current event that's going on in the community, some famous person, or a joke about Star Wars, Indiana Jones, or some other major film that is known by a majority of Americans. And then the pastor will go on to finish off his sermon with a message about Jesus and what he can do for your life, how he can benefit your life, and how you can accept him as easy as a 1, 2, 3 pray after me prayer, and you can be assured that you are going to heaven as long as you said that prayer and you really meant it. And after that, you will go home and continue life as normal. This is the church system nowadays that's going on in approximately 90 to 95% of churches here in America. And I'm going to be exposing today everything that's completely wrong with this system and how this system can be damning your soul to hell. How this church system is set up to sell you an American Christianity that's compromised, watered down, fake, powerless, and is completely void of the power of God. If you have an ear to hear, continue to listen of how you've been lied to by the church system here in American Christianity. So there are many terrible problems that are going on in American Christianity nowadays, especially how the gospel is presented, which a majority of the times is actually a false gospel that cannot save, for there is no preaching of the judgment of God. There is no preaching of the fear of God. There is no pointing out of sin anymore, but there's only self-help messages. There's only encouragement messages that don't offend anybody whatsoever, that give you a little comfort with God to make it seem as though you have a little bit of a better shot of making it into heaven one day. And the messages that are presented in American Christianity in the church system are completely void of the preaching of the holiness of God. And oftentimes, the unconverted person that is living like a devil the rest of the week, that is living just as worldly and as sinful as the rest of the unconverted world, is brought into the church and they are told by a pastor or an evangelist how much Jesus loves them. Little do they know that they have sinned before a holy God. Little do they know the wrath of God is currently abiding on them. Little do they know they need to repent. Oh, but yes, in American Christianity, repentance is not preached on. Being born again is not preached on. These major foundational truths to the gospel are nowhere to be found in American Christianity. I know I can personally relate to this. When I was growing up in American Christianity, I heard nothing about being born again. I heard nothing about repentance of sin. I heard nothing about the judgment of God. I heard nothing about the fear of God. But I heard a little message about how if I accept Jesus Christ into my heart, that I can one day make it to heaven, that I can be assured that I'm not going to have to go anywhere else, which they don't even mention anywhere else. They just say that if you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, that you can enter into heaven. But I challenge you to find a place in the Bible that says to just accept Jesus Christ as your Savior into your heart. It's nowhere to be found in the Bible. But nevertheless, these pastors here in America want to preach a watered-down, compromised gospel that doesn't tell you about the holiness of God. You have to understand that it's a revelation of the holiness of God that brings you to a true revelation of God's character and His severity. But nowadays, these churches are not preaching on this whatsoever. And when somebody might show a little interest in escaping hellfire, they might show a little interest in the things of God, or perhaps they were even drugged into church by a family member, they will thus appease a pastor by saying a little 1-2-3 pray after me prayer, where if they accept Jesus into their heart, they're pronounced born again, a brother in Christ, a new creature, before the entire church, but they're still living like an unconverted devil. They have no power of God in their life. They have not overcome any of their sin. They can't even confess Jesus Christ properly. But for the pride of the pastor, for the sake of having numbers for the church will pronounce them our brand new brother in Christ, yet they're still a goat. And then from now on, after that, the church will go on to spend the next 30 years discipling a goat as though it was a sheep. And then they have to continue to plead with this false convert to continue to come back to church Sunday after Sunday after Sunday to just receive a little enough encouragement to continue to go back to church. But when you're truly born again, you don't have to have somebody to plead with you to make it to church. You don't have to have somebody to plead with you to say a little pray after me prayer every single Sunday. You don't have to do these things, but when somebody is truly regenerated by the Spirit of God, their heart is changed. They have new affections. They desire the things of God, and they die to themselves. But a die to them yourself message is not preached in American Christianity. No, not anywhere even close whatsoever. And then the church is confused. Why they are losing people as fast as they are gaining them, why people are walking out of the church as fast as they are walking in, when they're trying to disciple a goat as though it was a sheep, when that person never went through a transformation, where they never truly picked up their cross and followed after Jesus Christ. But yet, once again, this is yet another message that is not being preached in American Christianity. Repentance and denying yourself and picking up your cross and following after Jesus. Yet these were the two of the most foundational teachings and preachings of Jesus Christ in his ministry. Oh, but the words of Jesus Christ are hardly anywhere to be found in American Christianity. Just a couple verses here and there from Paul twisting about grace to get the person to be added to the number of the church. What a true shame it is. When I came out of the New Age and I got converted, I started to go to different fellowships. I started to go to different churches in hopes that things will possibly be different now that I have truly changed, that I will be actually able to fit in with these people at the church. But to my surprise, there was still a major disconnect between me and the people that were going to these churches. And this didn't make any sense to me. But as I started to read the Bible, as I started to read the words of Jesus, I realized that a majority of these churches that I'm going to, a majority of the people that are standing around me, are just as untransformed as I was when I was an unconverted sinner, when I was a fake Christian in the church, and also even when I was a New Ager, and even more so because people are going around with the name of Christianity, yet they're living lukewarm. Jesus warned about being lukewarm that he will spew you out of his mouth if you were lukewarm. It would be better if you were cold or hot, but because you are lukewarm, he's going to spew you out of his mouth. And I think that's the case with a lot of American churches today, with American Christianity. People are blind, miserable, naked, wretched, and they don't even know it. They're completely blind to their sin. In their arrogance, they think that they are doing good things for God by attending church on Sunday, by saying a little 1, 2, 3 after me prayer, and by singing songs to God where their heart is completely void of the affection of the things that they're saying. Ask yourself the question, when you praise to God in church and you say, all for you, Jesus, I love you, Jesus, I'm not turning back anymore, I'm free in you, Jesus Christ, do you really mean these things? Jesus said, by your words you'll be justified and by your words you'll be condemned. Jesus also said, they draw nigh unto me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. Do you truly have a transformed heart? Are you truly born again? Are you a new creature in Christ? Or is your heart hardened to the gospel? Is your heart hardened to the words of Jesus? Or have you not even taken the consideration to read the words of Jesus Christ for yourself? But nevertheless, as I started to go to these churches, God started to place upon my heart to leave these churches because they are lukewarm and the power of God was almost completely void. The power of God was moving upon my life, but in these churches, it was pretty much nowhere to be found. And I think that the lack of the preaching of repentance, biblical Christianity, and the hard messages of the words of Jesus Christ that are completely void from the church is one of the main problems. But these pastors just want to give feel-good messages. They just want to be men-pleasers. They would rather feed somebody in a watered-down truth than offend them. They want to be men-pleasers. They want to grow the numbers of their church. They have an agenda. They have a scheme. They have it set up to draw in numbers. They don't really care if you can stomach the hard words of Jesus Christ. What about Jesus, when Jesus said, if you don't hate your mother, your sister, your brother, you are not worthy to be my disciple? What about when Jesus said, deny yourself, pick up your cross, and follow after me? What about when Jesus said all of these hard things? Are these messages being preached in the church that you're going to? If not, you might be in the church system. You might be in American Christianity that I'm talking about. But these pastors and these church leaders care more about their own growing their own kingdom. And some people might say, well, it's loving of them to be preaching these comfortable messages, these messages that don't offend people. But the Bible actually says that the word of God was preached with much contention. In 1 Thessalonians 2:2, we see, but even after that we have suffered before and were shamefully entreated, as you know, at Philippi, we were bold in our God to speak unto you the gospel of God with much contention. Do you see that going on in the churches nowadays? Or do you see people just giving amen to every word that comes out of the pastor's mouth, while a majority of the people inside of that church are living just as ungodly as the world? They're still living in their drunkenness. They're still living in masturbation. They're still living in adultery. They still love the things of this world. They watch worldly movies that mock Jesus Christ, and they laugh at the very movies at which God is completely disgusted with. But they're under deception. You might be under deception if you're in this church system. These messages often preach about what God will do for you, that God is right there for you, that God's grace will never outrun you, that you can never outsin God's grace, that Jesus is always rooting for you. But if you're still living in sin, you're an enemy of God. What if you fail God? The Bible says, beware, my brethren, lest any of you fail at the grace of God. So these churches will preach about your best life now, what God can do for you, how God can give you self-help messages, how God can help out your marriage, how God can help out and be the icing on the top of the cake for your life, is the way that these pastors and these preachers preach about Jesus Christ nowadays in the church, in American Christianity. But that's a false Christ if that's the case, because you have to be born again. You have to be radically transformed from the inside out, and you have to die to yourself. Have you heard that message before? Have you heard about when Paul said, "I die to myself daily"? Have you heard these things? Or have you just heard a couple verses about how Paul talked about grace so your pastor can twist them and deceive you about grace? Grace is not a license to sin. Grace is not a means by which you can go on living your same lifestyle, but if you truly were under grace, sin would not have power over your life. You would be transformed. The grace of God is not so you can continue on in your sin, but it's the chance, the opportunity for you to get out of your sin. But this is the deception of grace, that these pastors will preach grace in such a manner that completely devoids the conviction of God, that completely rips away any revelation about the holiness of God, and it's truly a shame. I remember just recently, I was preaching on social media against sin, and there's this one Mormon specifically who commented under the post who claims to be a Christian and was trying to teach me and was insinuating that I was driving away people from the gospel, that I was making people feel bad, that I was making people feel as though that they were a sinner, that I was making people feel as though they had sinned, that they might be living like a devil, is what she was insinuating that I was doing. And no, this is not the case, because sometimes a stony ground needs to be broken with some dynamite. You don't see anywhere in the Bible the apostles or Jesus Christ going around sharing a gospel message of God loves you, of it's okay, your sin does, your God doesn't see your sin. You don't see any open air messages like that, but rather you see open air messages about flee from the wrath to come, about you stiff-necked and hardened in heart, you always do resist the Holy Ghost. And these open air messages about cut your hand off if it causes you to sin, or pluck your eye out if it causes you to sin, for it would be better to go into life maimed than it would hellfire with one of your members. This is how serious sin needs to be preached about. But people will say that you're being unloving, that you're just driving people away when you preach these radical messages. But little do they understand, the unconverted is already driven away from God. They've already rejected God. And I think that America has been pampered with John 3:16. Yes, they've been comforted with messages like John 3:16 and only messages about love. And when you only talk about love and you don't truly show love in your preaching, it really shows that you're selfish and unloving. Most of the pastors that only preach a message about love are some of the most unloving pastors. It finds out to be that their messages are that of the most unbiblical. They don't tell people about God's holiness. They don't preach the law of God. Some people get afraid when you say to preach about the law of God, but the Bible says the law is the schoolmaster to bring us to Jesus Christ. But people want to remove the law. They want to remove preaching about sin. And then people don't have a proper understanding of salvation. See, it's important to understand that it's an understanding of how much we are deserving of damnation that we realize how bad that we need a Savior. If I just tell somebody, oh, you can be forgiven, oh, God loves you, but they haven't even been convicted by God of their sin yet, that they're miserable and wretched, that they've sinned before a holy God and they're deserving of eternal damnation, me telling them about God's love and how they're okay with God can actually be what's selfish, can actually be what's driving people away from the gospel. Because if I'm misrepresenting God and misrepresenting the doctrine of sin and holiness and God's character, that can actually give people a false assurance. And that's what's going on in American Christianity. Oh, I hope that's not the case for you, that you've been given this false assurance, this fire insurance, that you just say, oh, 1, 2, 3, powder puff, prayer after me. And because you maybe felt good when you said the prayer, that you're assured a guaranteed ticket into heaven. No, this is not the case. Yes, there is the means by which we should pray to God. A prayer of salvation is not unbiblical. But if you are not given the revelation that you've sinned before a holy God, that you need to repent of your sin and believe on Jesus Christ, not as though just a mental assent of the acknowledgement of a couple doctrines, but to believe on Jesus Christ as though hell is about to swallow you up, if you don't have that true type of belief, if you didn't truly fear God when you came to conversion, there's something terribly wrong, and you might be deceived by American Christianity, because the Bible says the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. By mercy and truth is iniquity purged, and by the fear of the Lord men depart from evil, is what the Bible says. So does this mean we should be uncompassionate and just be like a prideful street preacher in our mentality and show no love and don't preach anything about how God loves us, about how we can cast our cares upon Jesus, about how we can find a light yoke in Jesus Christ? No, those messages should be preached, but that should never be to devoid the messages about repentance, to devoid the messages about holiness. That should never replace the spearhead messages about holiness, because without holiness, no one shall see God. Oh, but if the word holiness was mentioned today in the church, I think about half the church on average would get up and walk away. They don't want to hear about the holiness of God. They don't want to hear about repentance of sin. And if a pastor does start preaching about repentance of sin, they know that a majority of the people inside of that church are going to get up and go find the more comfortable church in town. And they fear that those people will walk away. So in their pride, in their selfishness, in their fear of man, they continue on with these powder puff compromised messages that damn people's souls to hell. And actually, with a majority of these churches, these mega churches, these prosperity gospel churches, these compromised Christianity churches, it's actually the judgment of God. God allows these churches to go on because people would rather buy a watered-down lie, a watered-down truth, which is actually a lie, as opposed to the whole truth of God's word. You need to take the whole truth of God's word into consideration. You can't just pluck out John 3:16. You can't just pluck out verses about love and hold on to those verses and ignore all the words of Jesus Christ. If this is what you have done, you might need to tear down the fake foundation which you have built upon sand, and you might need to dig deep. That's what Jesus said. The one who truly built his house upon the rock was one who dig deep, really sought out God, really cried upon the name of Jesus Christ, really went into deep repentance and spent a lot of time seeking out God, following the commandments of Jesus Christ. But if you think that you can just go into church on Sunday, you can hear a message that you're doing God a service, and then you go out and live like a devil the rest of the week, you're utterly mistaken. You've deceived yourself. You've been deceived by American Christianity. And this church could actually be God's judgment upon you. So you need to flee this church. You need to flee American Christianity and read the words of Jesus Christ for yourself. But as far as these messages that these pastors preach, it's almost as though the same type of feeling that always goes on in this American Christianity type preaching. It has this overtone of motivational speaking instead of that of preaching about biblical salvation and flesh denial. It always gives this tone of, yeah, just keep going, keep on going. You know, God's going to see you through it. God's going to do this for you. God's going to bless you. And God will bless your life if you truly follow after his son. But to be rich in the Holy Ghost, not so that you can just find comfort inside of your flesh, not so that you can live an easy, best life now. The Bible promises tribulation. The Bible promises attacks from the devil. The Bible promises persecution from the world if you're following after Jesus Christ. And I think the opposite is the case with these pastors here in America. The Bible says, woe unto you when all men speak well of you, for so did they of the false prophets in Luke chapter 6. And you think about some of these pastors, they're some of the most well-known, well-respected people inside of the community. But this should be a major red flag, because Jesus said, woe unto these type of people. And it's really just too bad. So you need to flee today and seek the Lord while you can be found. Is there anything wrong with the church building? No. Is there anything wrong with a congregation of believers. No, the Bible says do not forsake the assembling of others, but it's never at the cost of a compromised, watered-down, false gospel. You don't continue to buy into a gospel that is being preached at a church just because you want to continue to fit in with the crowd. Because if that's the case, you still have the worldly mindset. Is your church just as does it have the same worldly mindset as the world, where it's just going along with tradition, with it's just going along with what feels right? You might just still be a false convert. You haven't truly been born again yet. Because the Bible says, if any man loves this world, the love of the Father is not in them. And if you truly do love the Father, you're going to hate the things of this world. And that's yet another message that's not being preached in the church whatsoever. If you've ever gone to a church here in America, and you feel like, I don't see why I'm even going here. I don't really see God manifesting himself here. I don't really see biblical things happening here in this church. Don't blame God because you don't see the power of God flowing in that church. Just realize that you might actually be in a church that is actually just a building full of people that use Christian lingo. Is that the case with your church that you go to? Is it just a fellowship of people that use Christianity lingo and talk about God? Or does it truly reflect the things that are going on in the Bible? Do you see the power of God moving in the church that you go to? Do you see biblical miracles? Do you see deliverance from demons? Do you see people that truly have a hungering and thirsting after the righteousness of God, or just people that want to go to church to make themselves feel good? They put on their religious makeup on Sunday and they go to church so that they can punch in their time card and feel good about themselves. But this is most definitely not the case. Then these pastors as well give a feel-good message. But sometimes the word of God needs to tear you down. Sometimes you need to hear preaching that is hard, that breaks down your stony heart. Because sometimes there's stony ground that needs to be broken with some dynamite before it can be properly planted with seeds. And then, once you truly come out of this church system and follow the words of Jesus Christ, you will not be a goat that's trying to be led around in a sheepfold, but you will truly follow after the shepherd, the bishop of your soul, the Lord Jesus Christ. These churches wonder why they can't get the sheep to follow after the shepherd on their own devotional, personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And they have to continue to keep encouraging them to do so every week. It might be because they're still a goat. They're not truly of the sheepfold of Jesus Christ yet. And it's because these pastors want the people in American Christianity to continue to depend upon the church system. They don't want them to become independent from their numbers, from them fleecing the flock, from them deceiving and making merchandise of the flock. This is what's going on in American Christianity. You have some preachers that are millionaires, and they're making merchandise of the flock, is what the Bible warned about in 2 Peter. So open your eyes and see, is your pastor merchandising you? Is he telling you these feel-good messages that are really just lies, that are false doctrines that could damn your soul? If he's not preaching about repentance, he's not preaching about the judgment of God, he's not preaching about being born again, he's not preaching about turning from sin, enduring, fighting the good fight of faith, if he's completely void of spiritual revelation, you might need to ask yourself if that's the case for the church that you are going to. And we see that biblical encouragement and edification is not that of just feeding you messages that feel good to your flesh. But we see actually a biblical definition of exhortation in Luke chapter 3, verse 18. It says, talking about John the Baptist, after he just preached about flee from the wrath to come, bear fruit worthy of repentance. Every good tree that does not bear good fruit will be hewn down and cast into the fire, it says, and many other things in his exhortation preached he unto the people. So that's what true exhortation is, because that will drive you to your knees to cry out to God that he would give you power over sin, that he would have mercy over your sin, and that he would truly empower you to be able to live that holy and righteous lifestyle that you need to. So like I said, we must not ignore the verses that talk about casting your cares upon Christ, that talk about we have been bought with a value by the blood of, or we have been bought with a price, and we are favored and highly blessed by the blood of Jesus Christ, that we can find comfort in Christ, but it's never at the expense of taking away the conviction of God from people or forfeiting the preaching of repentance and self-denial to be replaced of these things. So you need to ask yourself, do you have a true understanding of what true love is? Because true love warns the people about the wrath to come. Jesus said that there was none other born among women greater than John the Baptist. And what was John the Baptist preaching? Flee from the wrath to come. O you generation of vipers, who told you to bear fruit worthy of repentance? Who warned you to not bear fruit worthy of repentance? So you want to talk about love. The Bible says to not love only in word, but also in deed and in truth. And this is something that the pastors are not feeding the flock true love, but actually a fictitious, fake love. The Bible warns of this in Romans 16:18. For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ, but their own belly, and by good words and fair speeches deceive the hearts of the simple. So don't be of the simple-minded. Learn the wisdom of God. Fear God. Depart from your sin. Search the scriptures for yourself so that you're not easily deceived by these hirelings. And that's what a majority of pastors and preachers are in America. They're hirelings, and they don't truly care about the things of God. They just care about numbers, about church growth. They're completely obsessed with the next scheme that they can find for church growth. But what does church growth even matter if the people's souls are still damned, if they're not actually saved? And you need to recognize that you need to turn away, that you can't entrust yourself to every word that your pastor says. Yes, you should honor them. Yes, you should be comfortable with your pastor, but you should not be entrusting them, especially when they're preaching down these watered down fake messages and aren't preaching true holiness and repentance of sin and faith. Oh, they'll talk about faith. If you just have the faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move mountains. But they don't teach you that by faith you need to overcome the world. By faith you need to turn from your sin and follow after Jesus Christ. Oh, they'll say we need to separate discipleship and salvation. No, Jesus said, if any man follows me, he shall not abide in darkness, but he will have the light of life. So, I truly would hate to be one of these powder puff preachers on Judgment Day. When you're giving an account, when they're giving an account for the souls of all of these people that they lied to about grace, that they didn't teach true repentance to, how terrible of a place that would be. And you don't want to be even sitting under these pastors as well too and buying their false doctrine. 2 Peter 2, 1-3 says, but there were false prophets also among the people, even as there shall be false teachers among you, who privily shall bring in damnable heresies, even denying the Lord that bought them, and bring upon themselves swift destruction. And when these pastors tell you a watered-down truth, that's really a lie. When they're not telling you the truth, when they're not warning you about the wrath of God, that is saying something. When they're not saying something, they are saying something. And it goes on to say, and many shall follow their pernicious ways, by reason of whom the way of truth shall be evil spoken of. And through covetousness shall they with feigned words make merchandise of you, whose judgment now of a long time lingereth not, and their damnation slumbereth not. So this is saying that a swift destruction is coming upon these pastors, upon the churches, where they are preaching these false messages. You need to have wisdom. You need to have the wisdom of God to not be so easily deceived. And you need to turn away from these pastors that are making a merchandise of you. If the church looks just as carnal and sinful and looks like a carnival, just like that the world does, it's organized in such a same fashion, you need to recognize that you're still in the world. Just because it's called church, just because you hear a pastor preach a message on Sunday, does not mean that that person is truly influenced, is truly inspired by the Holy Ghost, but they might just be putting on a facade. So have your eyes been blinded? You know, like Jesus said, I counsel of you to buy eye salve, that your eyes be opened up, to buy, you know, to go through the true fire. And that's what you need to go through, for our God is a consuming flame. You'll either be burnt up in the flames of hell and suffer everlasting damnation, or you need to go through the fire of the Word of God to burn that sin out of you, to break down your hardened heart, that you could truly follow after Jesus Christ and deny your flesh, because sitting in American Christianity keeps your flesh comfortable as all ever, just as you were living a worldly, devilish lifestyle. And I remember, for me personally, even as I was growing a little bit older, in about middle school, I had this pastor that I went to his youth group. I went to, you know, even this retreat, this camp, this quote unquote Christian camp that he wanted to bring us to, and all of these different things. And we had a great time with the pastor, and I thought that he was a really nice guy and all of these things. But now looking back on it, he did me a complete disservice. He never told me about repentance. He never told me about being born again. And when my when I started to get into drugs and into the new age, and when my parents sent him sent me back to him to for him to try to talk some sense into me, he just reassured me that he still saw Christ in me. While I was still sitting there telling him about the new age and just blatantly showing how interested I was in the new age, he reassured me that he could still see Christ in me. And I think this is the error of so many youth pastors, so many pastors in American Christianity. They're selling you a false assurance. When you true assurance is abiding in the fear of God. True assurance is turning from your sin. True assurance is being radically born again by the Holy Ghost, where you hear his voice, where you follow after him, and you don't follow after these hirelings, these robbers, and these thieves. And I think the pastors are the main ones to blame. They're completely void of spiritual understanding. Yet in their pride, they talk about, oh, look at all my numbers. I got 500 candles lit here. Look at all the people that I saved. I got 5,000 people at my retreat that I just went to. A packed full house. Well, Jesus didn't have a packed full house. Actually, when he preached, everybody left him but the 12 disciples. Now, is that not to say that other people didn't end up getting saved here and there? No, but when these pastors are prideful and everybody in town goes to my church, that should be a number one red flag. And I just see this time and time going on and again in American Christianity, just with somebody that I even evangelized to personally. He's like, oh yeah, I love church. Church is great. My church has, we have 200 people in the church that we go to. We got so many people going to our church. And I'm just sitting there thinking, that should be a red flag unto you. 2 Timothy 3:3-4 says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust, they shall heap themselves teachers having itching ears, and shall turn away their ears from the faith, and shall be turned unto fables. And this is the case going on. American quote-unquote Christians are always going to the next seminar. They're always looking for the next head knowledge. They're always looking for the next piece of encouragement, but they forgot the foundational things of following after Jesus Christ, of praying, fasting, turning from sin, denial of self, evangelizing, fulfilling their calling, and all of these different things. And they have an itching ear. Do you have an itching ear? Are you willing to listen to the hard words of Jesus Christ? Are you willing to listen to the things that I'm saying to you? I plead with you to turn from the church system. Turn from the wrath to come, because the wrath of God is coming upon this American Christianity church system. And I say these things speaking the truth in love. Oh, these pastors want to talk about speaking the truth in love, and they give this compromised, watered down, man-pleasing message. They're not speaking the truth in love. They're speaking their selfish, compromised message. That is what I have to say to you. I plead with you. Read the words of Jesus Christ. Don't follow after this church system and think that just because you go to church on Sunday, you lip sync a couple songs, and you said a prayer of salvation, that you have a guaranteed ticket into heaven. Oh, the statistics say that so many people are Christians in America, but Jesus himself said, when I come back on the earth, will I find faith on earth? how skewed the perception is of what a true Christian is here in America. So you need to examine yourselves to see whether you be in the faith. Look through the scriptures. Do the scriptures align up with your life? Do you align yourself to the Word of God, or are you just taking a couple scriptures to twist to align to your comfortable, compromised, fleshly lifestyle? Which one is it? You have to ask yourself. As Paul the Apostle said, examine yourselves to see if you're in the faith, whether you be reprobates or not. And that's something that you have to do. You have to seek out God personally. And if you're in the church system, be open to the idea that you could be living a lie, and you need to come out from among them, is what the Bible says. Oh yes, 2 Corinthians 6:17 through 18. Wherefore come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you, and I will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. So like I said, if you've been sitting in American Christianity, the church system, and you don't want you wonder why you don't have that connection with the Father, don't blame the false church that you're in, but blame that you haven't truly sought out God for yourself, that you may have bought into a lie so that you don't have to truly deny yourself. But you need to deny yourself and have true belief in Jesus Christ, not just a mental assent, but believe on him. And if you believe on him, you're going to obey the words that he commanded. Because going around calling yourself a Christian while you live like a worldly devil that has not forsaken his sin, that has not truly been born again, is just bringing greater damnation upon yourself. That's all you're really doing. You're just giving Christianity a bad name if you are living a compromised lifestyle that doesn't reflect the words of Jesus Christ. And you might be wondering, how can I do this on my own? And that's the exact place that you need to come to, that you can't do it on your own, that you need the mercy and grace of God, not to continue on in your sin. Jesus didn't die so that you could continue on in your sin, but he died so that we can be forgiven and so that we can be saved from our sin. That's what the Bible says, not that we would be saved in our sin, but that Jesus shall save us from our sin. So you need to repent and be born again today. Seek the Lord while he may be found, because the door is closing and God's judgment is coming upon America and American Christianity. So come out from among them while you still have the opportunity to.